We're going to see the Destroyer wrestle Victor the Bear. He stands 6'6" when he's up.
The promoter had brought the bear, the wrestling bear, to San Jose. And then you hear an announcement, ladies and gentlemen, we ask anyone here in attendance, if they want to be part of the show, please raise your hand and fill out this form. And there my dad was. Yo, yo me meto, cabrón, ¿qué pasó? And I'm like, oh my God, my dad's gonna wrestle a bear. And I'm in tears, no, dad, don't do it, don't wrestle the bear. They never let my dad, but there my dad was in line. Now I wish I could find a wrestling bear, because if we did, I'd find a Mexican bear and an American bear and then make them wrestle. Watching pro wrestling, it's like I remember. I can recall my dad telling, hey, vamos a las luchas, vamos a las luchas, vamos a las luchas. And, you know, being 5 years old and, you know, and 3, 4, 5 years old, and you're like, ¿qué son las luchas? You know, what is it? And I remember my dad grabbing the paper and telling me, and he goes, mil máscaras, dos caras, Chavo Guerrero, Hector Guerrero, Mando Guerrero. The promoters, yeah, would bring the Mexican luchadores either as a special attraction to wrestle each other, or every so often they'd cross over and be part of the main events. The American people that were there would boo them. They'd boo, you know, and then you hear a little roar from the back, ese mis máscaras, ¿qué pasó, cabrón? You know, and people are screaming. I'm like, I'm confused. Why are we cheering? And then why is everyone booing? Now, 2008, 2009, and moving forward, the Hispanic community and our country, it's much diverse now. Cuando hago yo mi promoción, when I do my promoting now, is I try to bring a little bit of Mexico, the same way I remember my dad seeing Mil Máscaras and going, oh my God, Mil Máscaras is here. Tengo mi mamá y papá que pues ven la lucha libre, pero también vi lo americano y lo quiero combinar. Pero ahora, el mismo modo que la gente buchaba Mil Máscaras, ahora yo lo cambié, ahora la gente aplaude a la raza, pero cuando ven la migra, ahora sí, ahora buchen a la migra.
This is the United States of America. You all need to produce some green cards right here, right now.
Obviously, I'm not a real. I'm not a real racist. I'm not, you know, you're not gonna find me in neo-Nazi laboratories or anything like that, organizations, but it's kind of when I walk into the venue, knowing that I'm part of the Border Patrol, you gotta get into that mindset somewhat. You play it as if you were Border Patrol, but we have more fun with it, exaggerate it, and it's fun. You get to yell and make people feel bad about themselves. It's good times.
Outside these doors will be buses to ship each and every one of you filthy illegals back to that dump that's known as Mexico.
Soy americano y mexicano. Tengo los dos lados y quiero siempre quise buscar un modo de combinar, pero al momento en esta área no ha habido mucha gente que lo ha hecho, pero que lo ha hecho con el modo que yo quise hacerlo, sin tener miedo. Mucha gente nunca no quiere hacer la migra porque piensan que la gente se va a ofender y que, ay, que es falta de respeto. Bueno, no es falta de respeto. No es falta de respeto, eso es una función.
Porque ustedes siempre pierden con todo. ¡Viva Puerto Rico!
Yo de la lucha básicamente disfruto todo y para mí estar en la lucha es un rato de relajación que se olvidan todos los problemas. Ese es meterme con aplaudir al luchador, admirar lo que trabaja, hacerlos enojar, a jugar con ellos. No me conocen, a veces me conocen después ya que se acabó la lucha y dicen que soy el papá de Gabriel. Pero me gusta hacerlo enojar y eso disfruto. Yo esas dos horas que estoy en la lucha libre, para mí es lo más bonito que hay, que se me olvidan todos los problemas. Disfruto el momento ahí.
I'm very fortunate that my family is a part of it with me, because if my family, if my wife and my daughter were not a part of it with me, I don't think I would be able to keep doing it. But 1996 was my first show, and I've been doing it nonstop ever since. The passion I have for pro wrestling goes deep. I remember my mom telling me, where do you go? Like, why? You're never around anymore. Your friends don't see you anymore. Where are you? I told you, I'm at the gym.
Empezaron los pequeñitos, bueno, a ellos se les llama enanitos, se les llamamos, nosotros somos minis porque, bueno, mi complexión no es como la de ellos, que estaban, son más chiquitos y más deforme. Y fue un paso que ellos abrieron y nosotros seguimos ya, porque la lucha de ellos era más cómica y nosotros era un poco más, más de contacto, más aéreo. Y pues la lucha libre nos ha abrido esas puertas. Para demostrarle a la gente que nosotros podemos también, y también nos ha abierto la puerta a muchos lugares y a muchas empresas también.
My friends think I'm crazy. They're like, where are you going after school? I have a really big respect for it because, I mean, I know a lot of people that they've hurt themselves actually doing it, trying to entertain other people, and that's really big to me. I have to work hard, dedicate myself to it. I have to take care of school first, because at my age, that's what I have to do. But I'm gonna do it, and I'm gonna try to make my daddy proud.